while we were on the front line, there was a boy, small boy. I saw his eyes. You are not Iraqi. You look at your eyes. It's different. I can speak the language, Yazidi. Can you speak that language with me? He said, no, I forgot my language. 4 years I'm with the ISIS. He was a suicide bomber who brainwashed by ISIS, and then all of them died. He was the only one who survived at that house. My name is Afshin Ismaeli. I'm a journalist and photographer covering war and conflict around the world. Since I'm Kurdish, born in Iran, most of my childhood was impacted by the war and conflicts around the Middle East. Kurds are the biggest ethnic groups which is without a country. They want to have their own country, but they have been divided between Iraq, Iran, Syria, and Turkey. I have seen this close to my eyes. I have been shot. I have moved a lot. That's shaped my life and had impact on my work. Here is the end of operation of Bagos. We were trying to shoot some female fighters, and when we went there, it was thousands of fighters who are coming for military pride and celebration of the end of ISIS. Many of that women got killed during the fight against ISIS. They have different motivations, like the first of everything, that the woman should not be suppressed by the men. They are fighting for free women. Here we have a photo of a female sniper during the war against ISIS. It's well known that they are the best snipers in the area. One of the ideologies of ISIS, if you got killed by a woman, you don't go to the paradise. So you will go to the hell. And that was challenging for ISIS because they wanted not to be killed by a woman. I photographed her while she was shooting at some ISIS fighters on the other side. She told us how her friend took her life because she was surrounded. She had to explode herself because they're going to be tortured, they're going to be raped. Then they just got killed, so she chose to kill herself. Here we are in Bagos with the Peshmerga female fighters. It's in the morning. Before the operation starts, we were on the hill and we moved 100 meters. They saw us and it comes shootings from everywhere. And suddenly a mortar landed just some meters away from us in the middle of that girls. One of them died immediately. These guys which were with them, they bring that girls back to safe place. And here the snipers are coming and he is shouting here for help. She got injured, she got a splinter in her body. The airstrikes coming. From you see the smoke here, see the faces. It describes a lot of the condition. Here we are in Mosul. It was the end of Mosul operation, end of Islamic State at that city. We were still at the city, and while we were on the front line, there was a boy, small boy, which comes out and he says, I'm Yazidi. Yazidi is a minority group. Most of the kids were kidnapped, women being tortured, and they killed all the men of that minority group. I saw his eyes. You are not Iraqi. You look at your eyes. It's different. I can speak the language, Yazidi. And can you speak that language with me? He said, no, I forgot my language. 4 years I'm with the ISIS. He was one of the 24 kids who was in that house. All of them were suicide bombers, and he was a suicide bomber who brainwashed by ISIS, and then all of them died. He was the only one who survived at that house. He survived, but unfortunately, his sister, she got killed. We managed to locate his family some days after. I have still contacts with him. I visit him every year when I am in Iraq. Here we are in the Al-Hol camp with the 70,000 inhabitants. Most of them are Islamic State fighters with their families. They have something like Al-Hizba, which is a moral policy. You should cover your face, otherwise you got punishment. It's really difficult to get an eye shot. I saw that scene when a lot of women gathering around one man who are registering that woman inside the reception center. You see a lot of blackness in that photos. I saw that eyes there staring at me in the middle of all blackness. It represents the Islamic State because the flag was black and everybody should wear black. Here we are in Hasaka, end of Islamic State. It's a big prison with the 5,000 Islamic State fighters. When they just opened the window that we could see inside was hundreds of people in a small room. We couldn't go inside like here because they were dangerous still. They could kill you. They had, some of them had weapons. Some of them joined ISIS because of the belief in Islamic State. Some of them come for sex. So I met a German guy who, in Germany, he hadn't had any woman in his life. And he just came to Syria to get many wives. Some of them got a lot of money, $5,000 monthly salary. And some of them, they believe in it. So different stories, different motivations. It was really shocking. I mean, like, they took people, they behead people, they killed people, innocents. And now the end of them is like that, in that prison, in that small room. They're gonna be in prison for many years,